going to go straight to Paul in Western Mass. Hi, Paul. How are you? Did I get Paul?
Yes, I'm well, yes, Basil. How are you doing?
I'm very good. Yes.
I had a question about a currency that you should be intimately familiar with, and that's the South African rand.
So, you know, it's funny that you say that. I rarely ever follow the South African rand. I mean, I, in terms of looking at the chart, I do want, you know, people talk about it because a great deal of our friends are South African. So yes, then they talk about it. But actually, as a chart formation, but when I picked it up and I saw your call, I quickly went to it. Of course, I couldn't find a USD SAR, and then I remembered it was ZAR. And I had it all notated, so I'm right there with you. But it's interesting because the South African rand and gold and the gold stocks, I've still got this chart. Let me just see if I can find this. I'm going to show you something quite, ooh, do I still have that? Yes, I do. There it is. So I'm going to show the chart just for a second. This is a chart of the ZA, dollar ZADOWD. So this is like the Dow Jones South African Stock Index. And I always follow it, and I'm always thinking, you know, gold's doing this, gold's doing that. Then I grab the chart, and it always has to remind me that the South African Stock Market Index is really a commercial index. It's the companies, South African companies. And yeah, they do have some gold companies on the market, but it doesn't reflect always the gold action. I always pick it up and say, oh man, that must be crashing, or that must be. No, it's just, as you can see, right, if you're going to be able to see the chart, you'll see this is a monthly chart, goes way back to 2001, I can go back further, but it just shows this big, almost like the Eiffel Tower, straight up to a peak E, and it pulled very sharply down, making it, now it's making a kind of a dreaded H pattern. So, funny that you should mention that, and I'm always a little embarrassed because I have to look up what the symbol is. So.
Well, I was just kind of calling for fun in that I was interested in real short term. We're going on a safari later in April, but the balance, we put a third down last fall when we made the reservation, and now the balance of about 92,000 rand is due by next Monday. So I've been, and I use TradeStation just as you do, so I've been watching it, and it's been moving up. So I'm thinking, okay, sometime this week I have to pay that balance, and it pulled back just a little bit today. And I was just curious what you thought, real short term, if it would keep moving up this week, or should I pay that bill today while I've...
I completely forgot. I had the same thing with a friend who was going to South Africa and doing the same thing. It was a little earlier last year, and we were looking at it together. So it's a wonderful thing to be going on vacation. I know that when I was in Sydney, Australia last month, it was very nice to be paying a bill and seeing it shrink by 35% or 45%. The currency favorability is really great. I remember when I was in South Africa last, which was way back in 2003, it's the last time I was there, it was like 15 to the rand, $1 was 15 rand. It was just amazing. You can get, I know Steve Rhodes was there, he loved it. He had a great trip, and he got just the finest wines and finest meals, and he was paying just like it was a hamburger here in the United States. So I'm going to say the difference between, I don't have it right in front, is it 1 to 13? What is, do you know the difference right now?
It's about 15.02 rand to the dollar
right now. I don't see it. You've actually, it's changed, actually it's quite a bit of time. So it's changed a little bit. It was down at this particular point. It was 13.39 on the 2nd of January. Right now it's 15.01, so it's gone up. I'm going to say to you, for the difference that you find with a bigger bull, within the range that it is right now, I can see it going to a leg D slightly higher, but from what I'm looking at, I would not be surprised if it starts to bump into resistance in the 15.13 to 15.28 level, and then just kind of get stuck there for a little bit. So And at this point, with such a big differential, it isn't that different. As you know what I mean? I'm saying that go from 1 to 15 or 1 to 14 and a half. Yes, it sounds like a big amount, but in the overall spectrum, it could have an eye blink move up or down, and that's kind of what you're dealing with. So I'd say this is pretty much the range. If you want wait a little bit, maybe it'll drop to the 14.92. But I think it actually looks like it wants to go to 15.12152. Yeah, I think it can go to 15.14 quite quickly. I don't know if you can scale in or if you have to make an actual final payment, but within the next couple of days, I don't think it's going to make that much difference. But it is a big difference.
No, it's not going to make a big dollar difference. I just thought I'd call you on it just to see. I didn't realize you haven't been back there since 2003, did you say?
Yeah, 2002 or 2003.
For some reason, I thought listening to you, you had been back there. I guess you must have been traveling other places.
Unfortunately, our trips are always big, long trips overseas because our family lives in so many different places. But, I have not been. And we were talking about it the other day. Maybe at some point we'll take grandkids, take them on a trip. I've never been to the I've never been to the game reserve. My wife has. We were going to go once, and I said, I've got some projects I have to finish. So you go, and I'll meet you in Cape Town. So my wife went with the kids, and they had a wonderful time. She'll never forget that in the game reserve. I've never been. My holidays were always going to Cape Town, which is one of the most beautiful cities. So I love Cape Town. So. I just haven't been back, but most of my friends have been all over the show, and they're always talking about the Victoria Falls and this and that, and I'm saying, I've never been.
So you haven't explored your own former backyard?
I tend to do that. It's like when we've been to Sydney, I haven't been around Australia. We just kind of been, maybe four times. My brother lives there. We know Sydney very well, and that's what we do. And of course, with 51 beaches in Sydney, we've managed to see just a few. And it's a beautiful city, it really is. So, maybe someday we'll get to go to South Africa. Yeah, these are long trips, so... It's good if are you going to split the trip or are you going straight directly there?
No, we're going directly. We fly through London and then change and from London directly to Cape Town. And then we'll be in Cape Town for a week and then at Kruger National Park on safari for a week.
Oh, that's great. Kruger National Park's really wonderful. But all the shows on that we see, like on the wild world of animals or whatever it is, anything to do with nature, I love those. Those are fantastic shows. So when are you going?
Middle of April, we leave.
Oh, okay. Well, hope we have a chance to speak before then. Also, I'm going to be following the Rand right now. I've got some reason for it. But the monthly chart should go to a leg D above 1550 at some point. Keep that in mind.
All right, thanks.
Thank you for calling. I appreciate that.